One, two. Mic check. Are you ready?
I'm ready, man.
Are you fired up?
All fired up.
For anyone out there that's looking on Twitch, Facebook Live, YouTube events. Twitch. We'll be live in a few minutes. Hello, hello, hello. Time to take your seats. Take your seats. All right. I can't freestyle. There's no freestyling here. Hello, hello, hello.
Hey,
Hello? All right. We should be starting shortly. One, two, one, two, one, two, one, two, one, two. Hello? All right.
No hay otro sitio?
Sí, de momento va a ser todo a través de...
Que no sé. No sé qué tengo que hacer.
¿Podemos cambiarlo?
¿Cómo?
Ya está. Es que no sé. ¿Esto funciona? ¿Lo tienen que utilizar? Está tocado.
Hi.
Yeah.
Okay, welcome to everyone. Sorry, one moment. What's going on? Was it fine?
Yeah. The closer it is, the better. Closer.
But this sound?
Yeah, it's on.
Okay. I was feeling a broom. Can I start? Okay. Hello everyone. My project, my first game. My first code application with in this bootcamp in IdleHack has been 1 to 50. It's a popular game in Apple Store and I think in Android Play too. And I wanted to do first of all a presentation to introduce myself. My name is Edward. My background is in graphic design and advertising, so I never did anything related with programming. I never taught any code before starting 3 weeks ago. So it has been a little bit challenging. but that I enjoyed the process. The technologies I used in this in this game has been HTML, CSS, JavaScript, and jQuery. Maybe I don't know if it's a proper approach to work to use jQuery and plain JavaScript to manipulate the DOM at the same time. But I wanted to get into both processes, and I use it together. Just to get into the knowledge of using both. And we are gonna meet the game. My game is 1 to 50. It's a simple game where you have to you get a random numbers in the screen from 1 to 25, and you have to go clicking on them from 1 to 50. When you touch on one, it converts to 26, so you go through all the numbers, and when you go to 50, you achieve the game. It's challenging because you have to have visual agility, and you have to find all the numbers as fast as you can. As you can see, this was a screenshot. my best time has been 46 seconds. A friend of mine, 36. Not bad. And let's play the game. This is a game. So we can see how it works. We have a countdown at the beginning, and then we go. As you can see, it's pretty simple, but it has its difficulties inside, programming the code. I don't know if anyone would like to try, but I want you to see all more or less all the process of the game. As you can see, maybe someone is better than me. Sometimes I doubt if I have all the numbers in the screen. But you can see, I don't know, I don't want to bother you watching all the process, but at the end you get it done like you saw in the screenshot. Get back to the presentation. And if you have any question to do about the game, I'd like to answer any questions. If not, I'm gonna give the microphone to another.
What was the most challenging part for you?
I think I cannot say a specific moment on the processing, on the coding process. I think it has been everything because I did nothing before of this, so it has been the first, as I said, it has been the first one. And every problem I found has had his process to try to solve, to try to control what's happening, what's going on inside the code, and trying to see where was the mistake. But everything in a whole has been challenging. Anyone else? No? So thank you. Thank you very much. Who's next? You want the that one?
Okay. Okay, guys. Welcome to my presentation about my little slot machine I've created. And here we go. So, first of all, who I am and why I'm here. I'm 23 years old. I studied business in Germany. And I wanted to learn to code. Because since I knew that you could actually code pretty good. And that was like around 17 years old. And I never really done it. I started a couple of times and never stick to it. So now things was a good opportunity now. And what I want to get out of this course, I have one or two business ideas I want to pursue. And I want to be able to do it myself, or at least understand everything that is required for a business idea or to start up something tech related. So coming to my game, this is where I got my idea from. Gambling, I like gambling, especially slot machines. And I wasted a lot of time playing those like after high school, and a lot of money as well. And I like online poker and everything else that has got to do with luck games and roulette and all that stuff. So I thought maybe build one my own. And this is what I wanted it to look like. You see a lucky seven game with the payout table and different buttons and all that stuff. And this is where I'm now. That's how it looks. Not too fancy, unfortunately, but we can maybe play a bit. So you start, insert the money you want to bet, maybe say 100, because why not? You can select a bet amount that you play every round you play the game, between 10 cents and 2 euros, for like pay here, and then the game starts spinning. And it shows your bankroll and the last win you won, and that stays there. Unfortunately, it takes a lot of time to win, actually, because, yeah, I don't think we'll actually see something to win, unfortunately. It takes a lot of time, but you win something at some point. Okay, so how it works, as I said, input, the bankroll gets updated constantly. Last win shows the last win you had when you won something, so that you keep on playing. That's typical for a casino game, so you actually, like, if you don't see anything you win, well, you don't think you win sometimes. So. And if you'd start, you can change your life, of course. So how it works, the thing is that the images don't actually move at all, so it's not an animation. And the thing is that the images are actually shown every time there's a code that selects a random image and displays it in the DOM of the HTML. And that runs like for 80 times in a certain interval. So every time the image you see might actually be the image that would win at that moment of time, unlike in real machines, where it's just some image and you think you see it, but that's a problem. And that was also my main problem, because at first I didn't know how to animate images, and I had the idea, okay, maybe I can just set an interval and show the images for every time the code runs. And at first it didn't work, then somehow it worked. Then I had the problem to grab the images that were shown at the end of the interval and separate them. They pushed them into arrays, and I don't know. At the end it worked again. And then I had problems with updating the bankroll related to the payout system and linking it all together, which was my main difficulties. But yeah, I could have done it. I wanted to do a bit more, or a bit more like side stuff or fancy stuff, but as I had challenges with the basic idea, which I thought was easier, and the way it works now, it's pretty difficult to add certain features to it, which I wanted, but yeah, that's where we are now. Thank you for your attention. If you have questions, just ask them. Okay. Thanks.
Hi guys, I think my wife is watching, so hi baby. So I did a game based on so Fat Monkey, the name of the game. Actually, who I am. Let's start with that. So I'm Juan Carlos. I'm from Puerto Rico. Previously working in the finance sector as a private on a company that does private equity. I was vice president, mainly doing analytical stuff and reporting, everything that is not related to sales. So, Fat Monkey. It's like I get the question, how did I came with that idea? I have no clue. I was doing a tic-tac-toe initially, then I figured out it was gonna be like too easy. So, and to be honest, after seeing the projects of the first group, I was like, there's no way I can do a tic-tac-toe. So I was like brainstorming for an hour and came with the idea of doing a game that is based on a monkey that you need to feed him like the right way so he stays in the right weight. So you can either get him too fat or get him too thin. He will not die because it's a kid's game, but you will lose the game. That's pretty much it. So structure and code. I mainly focus myself on what we learn in class, like doing JavaScript per constructor. So I have two JavaScripts, one for the main game and one that manipulates the monkey. And I have the HTML, of course, and the CSS. It's object-oriented, so it's based on constructors using the this word and with functions inside of it that I actually call as methods when running the game. So I think one of the unique things maybe about my game is how to make the monkey get thinner or fatter. So what I did was manipulating the CSS padding of the image. So each time a second passes by, the padding increases, so that way the image shrinks. Or if you fit him the right way, the padding decreases, that way the image increases in size. So it's pretty much, I think, the unique thing in the game. Also, I did like you will get a hint on how close you are about to lose, depending on the pace of the music. So if the monkeys get thinner or fatter, then the pace of the music is going to increase until it reaches twice the pace of the original track. Git, three branches, as we learned in class. Development, GHS pages, that's the link. And this is the link for the game, which I already opened in this tab. So that's the game. We start, press start here, then it will show the images. So I will try to feed him with as much fruit as I can. Because when you feed him with fruits, then you will get the higher scores. You can use dessert. It will help you like get him fatter faster. But then you lose points. So the idea, well, I lost. I'm not that good at my own game, so. The idea is that you get an alert with how many seconds you fed the monkey well and the score that you got when playing the game. So basically, the target is for kids. Let's say it's like a way for them like to what to eat to be healthy, like reach the right weight. Like you can get a dessert every now and then, but if you feed on desserts mostly, then you will get fat. So that's kind of the idea. And I have a kid, but he's too young to play the game. So in a couple of years, maybe, version 3 of the game. So any questions, guys? Any doubts? Any ideas for improvement? Any, I don't know. Where's the monkey? He's almost gone. He's at the right size. So here is where he increases or decreases in size. So this is all CSS with Flexbox only. No, I didn't use Bootstrap. So it's not responsive. Don't try to play on mobile. It won't work. I think that's it. Thank you.
Well, hi. Well, my project's name is The Pipe Game, as you can see. About me, well, my name is Alejandro Diaz. I'm from Mexico. I'm 32 years old. I have lived in Barcelona since 2010. And previous to coming to this Bucan, I have been working as a photographer, also as a C# developer a long time ago, and project manager also. Well, in my project, in technology, I use obviously HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. Also, I use the library of jQuery for the DOM manipulation and the framework of Bootstrap. Also, for the version control, I use Git and GitHub. About my code, I try to like put in practice everything that we have learned, well, kinda. The object-oriented programming, prototype objects, array, functions, methods, variables, and timing events. Well, about my game, it's kinda like a new version of the Leaky Pipes games. Like the main objective of the game is like to create the biggest path possible of pipes in a limit amount of time where the water can flow without leaking. I will show you how it works. Hold on. Here. There is an initial tab, and then you start like putting pipes. I don't think I'm gonna win, but okay. Fuck. It's quite complicated. fuck. I'm sorry. Well, I'm gonna lose. Anyway. 2 seconds, 1 second, and I lost. Well, actually, the main idea of the game is that after the period of time, water will start flowing from an initial tab, and randomly the direction will be start flowing, and if you lose, it will show you the leaking points of the pad, and if you win, it will tell you like how many points you made through the pad. And basically, that's the main idea of the game. Like, make the longest pad with the and make more points. Getting back to the presentation. And well, that was all. So thank you for your attention. And any questions or something? Oh, yeah. Oh. How do I connect the bytes? Well, initially, let me put you back. Hold on. Actually, that was like my main issue, because initially there is a random tab that will, where the water will come out, but you don't know the direction. So the player can put like different pipes all around the grid. And first, I have to get like the initial cell of the grid where the water will flow and the direction. And from then, I have to check like the, for example, here, if the water is coming down, I have to check like the next row, the same column. And from over there, I have to check the kind of pipe, because there are different kinds. For example, this, it has 3 exits. This is only 3. This is 1. This is 2. So depending on the pipe, it depends the direction of the water and how many, like, my method is recursive. It keeps calling itself, because it has to check like the next cell. But here, it has to check 2 cells. So that was like my huge problem, like to keep track of every call. But at the end, I think I managed to finish it, but it was quite difficult. Thanks. Another question? No? OK, thank you for your attention.
Oh. No. Aquí aparece, pero no ahí. Pero si no, aquí está, creo que si lo tocas aquí el display.
No, joder.
Hay una.
¿Dónde está el display?
No, pero no es ese, no es ese. Así.
Está. Ahora está.
Hi. Welcome aboard. My name is, I've been saying this phrase for the last 7 years. I used to be a flight attendant, so I've introduced myself to many, many people in the world. And during these flights, I've been thinking of changing my career so many times, and I've read through a lot of articles and investigated what's the next market for jobs and everything, and I discovered that programming, coding, whatever you want to call it, is the future and is where you have to go if you want to be part of the world of the next maybe 5 years, after 5 years. So yeah, I'm from Argentina. And I've been in Barcelona for the past, since the bootcamp started. I lived in Dubai for 7 years, and now I'm here to start maybe a new life here, or I don't know where. I chose the PEC Solitaire. I just found out the name in English now. It's a game I had on my coffee table for a long time. I actually know how to solve it. It's a puzzle. And it was a project where I had to focus straight away in the logic because the visuals or the layout is very simple. I called it the Black Pearl. That was after I finished it because I found out that I could put a theme on it and maybe change the how it looks in a normal game online, give it something different. The PEC Solitaire is a puzzle, as I said. It consists on a board with 33 cavities and 32 pegs, or marbles, or pearls in this case. You will have to move around the board, basically hopping on top of other pearls and eliminating them from the board until you're left with only one in the middle of the board. It's hard to explain written, but when you see it, you will see. So this is the board. You basically have to jump with the ball over another ball to an empty space, and then this ball will disappear, or pearl, or how we want to call it.
Challenges. Yeah. Well, I had the challenge of starting the game. Basically, when I started, I thought, okay, where to start? And then I started looking at games we've been practicing on our lessons. And with bits and pieces of other games, I started my own. Basically, it's a constructor with a lot of methods inside. The main method is called game move. And it's basically that method with a timer, with a set board, and with a start new. It's very simple code. It's very short, actually. But it helped me to start my new first game. Oh, this is my GitHub, how I've been working throughout the week. These are my commits. I have to practice on this because I was committing with a lot of changes instead of committing after every change. And this doesn't make it look very organized. So that's a thing to improve. Okay. Before going to the link, I'm going to show you some screenshots I have of the game. This is the main the main HTML where you are sent when you load the game. There's a description and how you should play. Then you press on puzzle, and you go to an empty board. You have to fill it up pressing start new. That's your board. As soon as you start the board, there's a counter here starting to count down from 10 to 0. So you have to start moving the balls, and they will start disappearing. If you take more than 6 seconds, it will tell you to hurry up. So it's the first warning. If you didn't hurry up, well, this happens. And you cannot play anymore. You have to start a new game. In case you continued playing, you will get to the solution, which is the last pearl, which should be black, but is white. This will change in the future, but yeah, that's the winning frame of the game. And that's it. I will just show you a bit how it... with the link, how it works. So there is just some introductory music in the first part while you read your explanation. Then when you're annoyed with it, you start playing and it stops. You start new. Then you move. I don't know why it's repeating what I say. And then that's it. If you wait, you will see how it gives you the first warning. And then you lose. So that's my game. Any questions? Sorry? Well, you have to find out. But it's a lot of practice only. Then when you start to think of the logic of how you have to move, if you want to practice your logic, you should play my game. Okay, that's it. Thank you.
So, hi everyone, my name is Cyril. I'm from Geneva, Switzerland. As you can see, I have a European background. I used to work as a sales trader in London and Geneva, and I decided to change career and try to learn some coding. So my game is about Trump Hunt. It's basically a revamp of the game of the NES. I don't know if you remember the game called Duck Hunt, which was made by Nintendo in 1984, and that it came out in Europe in 1987. I don't know if some of you have played from this game or you were young. So I use HTML5, CSS, JavaScript, jQuery UI, Bootstrap, and for the animation I use mainly animated CSS, and I use some Lodash to randomize some pickup from the animation. The font I use is a font that I found online from someone who made a font from Duck Hunt, and I put it online via freenom.com, and I use the blockchain and the ads from Bitcoin So this is the structure of the game. So this is the landing page. You have three main options: one where you can shot Trump, another one where you can shot Trumps and Putin, and the final option is to shot Putin, Trump, and Kim Jong-un. There's as well game setting options. So you've got different options. You can choose your crosshairs, you can choose your weapons, and there's different killing sounds when you hit the heads, as we will see later. So this is the first, on the left is the first one, is Trump only. So you start with three heads. There's seven levels. Every level, the speeds go faster, and there is one more heads in every level. So there's seven levels, and then you finish the game. The second option, the third option is with Kim. So you've got three different heads. You've got Trump, Kim, and Putin. And there's a hidden menu for Bitcoin donation. As you can see, no one has donated yet. I encourage anyone who wants to donate. So the biggest challenge I had on these games were to make the animation load at the right time, in a timely fashion, and to get the animated and to remove the heads that comes up every time, to remove them orderly as well. That was a bit of a challenge. As well, I didn't know that when you launch several set intervals at the same time, each have a different ID. So in order to make sure that that each head was canceled properly, I had to push them into an array, and then I had to loop through the array to remove them. So this is the code for the first function, animate top left CSS. So as you can see, it's straightforward. You just do a math random, which gives you a random number of the container, and then you return it, the top and left, and then the function animate image push every set interval into the array, and then in another function we clear the set interval for each created stuff. So there's a few bugs, unfortunately. I haven't been able to make it work properly with Safari, and the sound is a bit laggy as well on Safari. And on Firefox, the crosshair is a bit faulty. There's not much I can do about it, unfortunately, so it has to be like this. And that's it. Maybe someone would like to play? Any volunteer? No? The German guy? No? So normally there's sounds. Unfortunately, we don't have sounds, so it won't play. But you can choose your crosshair. And you can choose the sound of your weapon and the sound that the heads make when they die. So let's do Trump and Putin. So you have to kill each. Unfortunately, if you try to kill Merkel, you lose points and you lose time. You have 30 seconds on each game to kill off the heads. So yeah, that's about it. So there's 7 levels, and the more you go through the levels, the faster it gets, and the more heads there are. And that at the end, you've got a score as well, and at the end when you lose, you've got a screenshot of your score, and then there's a little animation about Trump laughing at you, basically. He's telling you you're fired. So there we are. Okay, anyone has a question? No? Okay, thank you.
So hello everyone. My name is Andreas. I didn't put a slide about who I am, so I'm gonna say who I am. I'm Andreas. I'm 32 years old, and I used to work in finance. I do have some background in computer science, but I haven't used anything for the past 7 years, 8 years. I like the digital world and being creative. So this coding thing is something related, basically, and I'm loving it for now. So it's a good thing. So the game I did is called Gemit, and it's my first project in the coding bootcamp. And I chose this specific game because it is quite challenging. I had to figure out a lot of things, basically, how to do the scanning of the gems and all these things. And it reminded me that with perseverance, you can achieve, like, complete anything you want if you really want to. A short description for this game. It's basically it's influenced by the gem crushing games. One of them, the really famous one, is Candy Crush. I mean, this does not compare to Candy Crush, but it's much more simpler. And you collect points by making combos when you crush gems. You swap gems and you crush them, basically. The first action is triggered by swapping one gem. My challenge was to create something simple and user-friendly, but mostly it was the coding part, creating random gems that don't repeat themselves, because if you repeat 2 gems, then they're going to crash automatically. And then create the correct if conditions to correctly scan the grid so that you can crash vertically and horizontally. So the gems were designed using Inkscape. I just did them really quickly. This is a sneak peek of the game, a small screenshot. The website was designed using CSS and Bootstrap, because it has a convenient grid system that I love, basically. I mean, the columns and everything, this looks good, I think. There were a lot of issues I need to resolve, as I said before. I did the game using constructors, and the major issue was the grid. Originally, I thought about doing it in one way, and it wasn't working out, basically. So it resulted, as I say there, that dropping the project at some point, I'm like, I'm not doing this. I'm going to do something else. But then I started from scratch, and I figured out a different way. Basically, this is how I did the first design on the left. It's the first design, and then I thought maybe this doesn't work because you have to push the gems on top. It's much better if I just put every column in an actual column and delete the cells and then add from the top. So the second grid was much more convenient. Yeah. The cells were created dynamically using four loops, and their IDs were customized so that they include the coordinates, basically. So 0, 1, 0, 2, 0, 3, and 1, 0, 1, 1. And I could extract these IDs every time and use them to remove and add new gems, basically. This is some snippets for this separate file of the gems. I created the URLs, basically, in the object, so I extracted the URLs directly and put them in the HTML. And then I made a code to iterate through each cell, basically. In general, I used a random Lodash. Some people don't like Lodash, but Lodash was useful for this. I used sample, basically, to get random gems. And I did a horizontal and vertical scan every few seconds, basically, to check the grid that there are three or four same color gems so they can disappear. Okay, this is an extra game I did because I actually dropped the game and I started working on this. Forget about it for now. Let's see the game. This is the game, basically. In order to start, you need to click on the start button, and there's a timer. It's 60 seconds. I can set it to anything I want. I chose 60 seconds, basically. And you crash the game. You start swapping the gems, and you crash them, basically. If you click on a black one, it's minus 5,000 points. If you match three, it's game over. And the bombs, if you click on them, if you match them, basically, you destroy all the same colors. And the bonus ones, you get bonus points and extra time. So a taste of the game is this, basically. I hope it doesn't crash. It won't. So you swap gems, and automatically they get refilled on top and keep crashing if it discovers new gems, basically, that need to be crushed. And the points add up. And if you click on a black one, you lose 5,000, and basically this is how it works. Now it's crashing because it keeps finding new gems. So this is my game. If you have any questions. No? Good.
Hello, everyone. If you're not already aware, my name is Ryan. I had zero programming experience before I came here, and after you see my game, you'll see that makes sense. Before I actually explain what the game is, I want to explain why I chose it, because it makes better sense that way. So, if you can't tell from my accent, I am from the United States, and while I don't normally like to associate with a nationality, about 8 months ago, my country got a little drunk and decided to elect this guy as our president. And unfortunately, in the process of trying to make our country great again, we came across a problem. And that's, this guy is obsessed with Twitter. And more importantly, he's obsessed with putting ridiculous stuff on Twitter that makes no sense, and it causes real problems for our country. It's so bad now that his staff have actually tried to create creative ways to distract the president of the United States from not using Twitter. And so I thought, well, that's a great idea. I can find a cathartic way to cope with my misery by simulating what it must be like to try to distract Trump on a daily basis. So my game is a simulation of a day in the life of a White House staff member in the Trump administration. So the concept is pretty simple. You are constantly given a crisis or a situation that you have to try to resolve. And there are correct ways to do it, and there are incorrect ways to do it. And if you do it correctly, Trump gets happy. If you do it wrong, Trump gets angry. And when Trump gets angry, he tends to do silly things. But just like in any White House, there are other problems you have to deal with. So it's not just Trump, there's other stuff that gets in the way. So you have to multitask, which is what I had to do with this game. So, as I said, I started off with very little coding knowledge. So as we had been warned in advance, there was a lot of concepts that we'd probably struggle with, and there'd be times during our boot camp where we'd have waves. And I can pinpoint the exact day. It was day 5 of week 1 in which I started feeling some quiet desperation. And that's when we were talking about these two guys, prototypal inheritance and DOM manipulation. So I didn't complete any of these projects on the right-hand side. So I wanted to create a game that used everything that we had discussed that I didn't understand and forced myself to learn. Biggest problem I had, because it's very easy, as you know, to create code that is extremely chaotic, it's extremely difficult to create organized chaos, because I had to find a way to make all this different stuff happen at the same time and have it work. And so a lot of asynchronous timers are going on, in which they're all related to each other to a certain degree. And so often I had to deal with the context of the function I was working with, because I had so many functions. And so that meant deciding what variables were global, which ones were local, was a real difficult issue for me because sometimes I didn't know where to put it. So there's not going to be any sound, which sucks. I spent probably about 4 hours trying to synchronize all the video with audio, but if you guys are ready, we're going to go ahead and make America great again. And that is actually Donald Trump tackling some guy in the WWE before he became president of the United States. So this is my game. A little introduction of how it works and what you're supposed to do. So it starts off like this. So you're confronted with a situation you have to resolve. There's three answers. There's a timer on the left, the approval rating in the bottom, and a timer. Now, as this red bar gets up, Trump is going to get more angry. I didn't get to finish him. And already I can't keep up the game. So a journalist is now asking you questions. I have to answer this question before I can deal with whatever I have to do with Trump. So I need to find the correct answer. That's not it. That's not it. Microwaves is the answer. Cool. Now I go back to dealing with Trump. I try to find the correct answer. Nope, he's more angry. I go here. Okay, problem solved. Now we have a new crisis we have to deal with. And so the idea of this game is that you cannot win. Eventually you're going to lose, right? Because you can only prolong the inevitable for so long. And so if I keep on doing this wrong, eventually what's going to happen is Trump is going to get so angry that he's going to do something stupid. He's going to tweet. Now, if you look here, the only thing that you can win in this game is accomplishments, because if you keep Trump happy long enough, he's actually able to pass certain policies, which are what are linked right here. So if you want to evaluate how good of an administrative official you are, you can look at how many things Trump is able to do. And that's it. Any questions? I didn't think so. All right.
I could use somebody's computer, but with the Linux thing, I don't know how to do it. Oh, all right.
Okay. Okay, so hello, and my name is Darek. My background is actually from computer science. I graduated from university. I also worked for as a developer for a couple of years. Then I moved on to other things, so this is not, I'm not a complete beginner, by no means. For the game, I chose this classic game from DOS called Rampart. It's a very lame game, by the way, but it allowed me to build something simple, then add to it. So that's why I chose it. And maybe I'll just show it. Okay, so we have a single player and multiplayer. What I need to do is build castle walls, place cannons inside it, and then shoot some ships. Right. Yeah, so I'm placing cannons. There are three cannons per round. So we got pirate ships that we need to kill, and they shoot at my wall, right? All right. Now the war is over, I need to rebuild the castle, otherwise I lose. Yeah, so it has to find the territory that is enclosed by walls and add it to the castle. And the whole process repeats. There's really no way to win this game, only lose. Yeah. Okay, there's also a multiplayer, and I have my arch enemy here, Giuseppe, ready to battle. So let's do that. Okay. Oops, sorry. Once again. There is still bugs. Still bugs. I didn't have a chance to test it with another player too much. So, all right, let's see. Can shoot, of course, he's shooting at me, so I'm gonna shoot at him. There are also ships, you know. There you go, man. I'm gonna shoot this guy also. Yeah, so as you can see, everything he does is mirrored like real time on the board. Yeah, so I don't think I can make it. Yeah, I'm gonna lose again. Yeah. Good job, Giuseppe. All right, so that's basically the game. There you go. What I used was basic jQuery and Lodash. I just actually used Lodash twice. The animations are from Animate CSS,
And there's also a very basic server on Node with sockets IO. The file structure is also very simple. All the classes are separated into their own files. I also have some helper functions that are in the global scope. And these are the classes in the game. So we have the game is the main controller, which is running the game, the logic of starting single player, multiplayer, and going through the stages of the game. Each stage of the game has its own controller, like builder for building walls, the cannoner to place cannons, and the war class, which runs the ships, right? And the player is, player classes have cannons. The controller classes communicate with the board class, which is only for displaying the graphics. that was for single player. With multiplayer, there's also a remote class that takes communications from the controller classes and sends it to the other player, and also receives communication from the other player and controls the board to mirror the actions of the other guy. So here's how it works in one way. So the game is running the controllers, which display the game elements on the board, and the controllers also, while they put something on the board, they send it to the remote class, which sends it through the server to the remote player, and the actions from the controllers are mirrored onto the board of the other player. And also the remote has some callbacks to the game class to inform about, for example, if the other guy loses. So this is the one-way stream, and it's mirrored the other way around. So basically, this is the whole structure of the game. All right. Is there any questions? Maybe. Yes, please. Yeah. Sorry? Exactly. Three players? No. The server side is very simple, so it broadcasts in mirrors communication to basically everyone who is connected at the moment. So with three players, it gets really messy. So. Yeah. I mean, the third player would see what the other two are doing, so maybe you can call it a feature. Right. Yeah. Shut up, man. Yeah, the princess left. Yeah. Ask Giuseppe. He won. He's got her. Okay. Well, there's no one else, so thank you.
Hello everyone, I'm Giuseppe, and this is my game, just another battleship game. And so I'm from Italy, I'm 27, and I'm a former biotechnologist, and I always like coding, so that's the reason why I've chosen this bootcamp. And so yeah, that's the game, basically. It's a game of battleship against the computer. The main feature is basically that has two levels of difficulty. It has a very retro styling. So yeah, the technologies used are JavaScript and Lodash for the game logic, and jQuery for DOM manipulation, and of course CSS, HTML5. And basically, I used the constructors and the prototypes for the logic, and the interface was only functional programming. And yeah, the technical challenges were basically positioning the ships on the HTML grid. It was very tricky, especially when positioning like vertical elements. And also building even a very simple AI was harder than expected. And in fact, I ended up using a mock AI, which basically cheats. And yeah, so basically this is my Git story. 24 commits, 3 branches, 1 master, 1 development, and GitHub pages for the deploy. This is the link. Yeah, this is the demo. So here we are, the settings. We can choose the difficulty. I don't know why it's not loading the image. So we go with potato. Oh, let's go with al. So the game ends faster. And yeah, so play. You choose the ships, you place it. Yeah, something like this. Yeah. Okay, so basically every time you shoot, the computer waits and shoots. And I had to set an interval because otherwise the shooting of the computer was triggered multiple times. And yeah, that's pretty much it, I think. I mean, you get a visual feedback when you destroy the ships. And you have the stats on bot, and there's a winning or losing animation at the end of the game when the game ends, hopefully fast. Okay, so I destroy this. Okay, so when you lose, we lose, and that's it. So control one, yeah. So the mistakes for this project was that I lost almost 3 days on another project that I ditched. The way I built the logic part made difficult to detect when the ship was sunk. And also, like, looking back, it would have been better to implement 2 players instead of doing players versus AI, because the game gets very boring. Like, after 2 games, you get bored. So yeah, that's it. So if there's any questions.
Why was it difficult to play the ship?
Yeah, because like you have to target since it's a grid, right? So there's rows. You have to target first the parent, which is the row, then the next parent, and then in that parent you gotta target the element depending from the index. And if you wanna check it out, it's on the GitHub page. And also, if you wanna check out the AI, which is dumber than a potato, by the way, it's on the development branch. So yeah, that's it. Thanks for listening.
special. Somebody is seeing the play button? But I want to play it. Where? Okay. Well, this is the Tartarus game. This is my project. I am Sergi. I am a telecommunication engineer that has not done a lot of coding, but I want to code full time right now. So I think that this bootcamp is going to help me. And I also want to learn the best and smartest practices coding, because right now my code is spaghetti coding, so it's not very efficient and beautiful to see. The game I wanted to develop, well, I wanted to do a classic, and I chose Tetris because of the pre-work that we have done previously and all the the work during these three last weeks. And the game is this. It's a very simple layout. So you have all of these options. You can play two players in the same screen. You can choose the points you have to get in order to win the game. And you can choose the level of difficulty of the game. The game basically is the Tetris, and well, it's not looking good in this screen, but basically you can go to the left, to the right, faster down, and you can rotate the pieces. Okay, this is not looking good in this screen. And you have the option to restart the game. And also, that we cannot see right now in here. I don't know if I can. Well, you can go back to the main menu. You cannot. Well, we are not seeing the option right now in here. Okay. You can go back to the main menu. You can choose to play another game, or you can resume the game. The game always begins post in order to get to give the player the option to start correctly. So, nope. Well, what was the challenge that presented this game? The challenge was to move the pieces and all the blocks that compose each piece through the DOM and make the game fluid. How did I overcome it? Well, I just position each block of each piece with the rows and columns of the grid where they are spawned, and I displace them in the DOM in pixels in using the absolute position through the grid, and the grid have a number of regions that has a center with a value of pixels. This is the snippet of the code. Doing that, I only have to refresh through the generated pieces, and the game can go more fluid than if I have to go through each region of the grid. How I update, erase, and displace the pieces, and I update the grid. Well, I only look at the regions with blocks, and I only look
the pieces. So as you can see in this code, I am doing loops with only the generated pieces, and I update the regions that have a block inside of them. And also I wanted to make this game multiplayer, because when I was a child, I used to play a lot in the Game Boy with my friends. And the concept, in order to do it, was to reference each one of the players inside of the other object. And I made it in the main object of the game, that is which controls the creation of the two players. So I do it just this way, it's pretty basic. And what are the conclusions that I take from the development of this project? Well, I managed to solve the basic problems that Tetris presented, but I think that I managed it in more time than I expected, so I could add more features into the game. I wanted to add some cooler features, like, for example, you can throw pieces to your adversary grid, for example, and I don't know. I think that it's okay, but it could be better. And also, I didn't have enough time to check the compatibility for all the browsers and all the type of computers, because in the beginning, when I sent to Hector the game, he told me that it was not working for Mac. So I was short on time for some of these things. And well, I'm finished. Thank you for listening, and if you have any question.
Well, hi everyone. I want to show you my first project in IronHack. It's a learning game. I'm Hector, and I'm from Asturias, a little region of Spain. I work in coal mining, and I am a musician. I'm learning in IronHack how can I work in JavaScript or jQuery. It's a new branch for me. What type of game I choose? I choose an educational game because I was looking something with a little curve of learning. Then it doesn't matter the age of the player to get knowledge without effort. Celtic team, because in my region, in Asturias, it's very, very, very feel that Celtic staffs. And the first and most important, I won't enjoy creating the game. The theme is it's Celtic because I am a bagpiper from more than 10 years. And it's a team who I know very well. How I done the play? I structure it with HTML and CSS with Bootstrap. I program it and animate it by jQuery. Treatment of image with Photoshop, and I manufacture it in El Audio in Ironhack by myself. I play my bagpipe here, and I cut the audio for the game. That's the game. Here. That's my game. Welcome to the first course in international of Bagpipe Asturian. With this course, you want to learn to play your first song. It's Hymn of Asturias. Enjoy learning. First, I show you the notes. You can see all the notes in the bagpipe. Fa, sol, all the notes. And now I let you to practice these notes. If you touch the note do, you can comprobate, and okay, it's a do. Now I and sound the do. Now I told you touch the re, and you can touch the re. If, for example, you don't touch well the re, I show you. Try again. And if you don't remember how is the note, you can go sections, learn the note, and let's see how is the re, or the mi, or wherever you want, and go again. When you touch all the notes and you feel strong, you can go to the in. That show you the first 9 notes of the Hymn of Asturias. It's the same, but that's the order of the notes for touch the Hymn of Asturias. For example, you need to play the do, later the mi, fa. It's okay. You learn, and when you touch the 9 notes, you can show the real bagpipers touching that in. It's cool. Well, that is the game. You learn, touch the bagpipe. So cool, no? Technical problems. Learn how to properly use Bootstrap and the placement of mobility images. It's very hard for me because I need put the image correctly for show you what I want. Implement the audio at the right time with jQuery. Fluid interactions and good feedback for the player. Because if you touch the button and don't, it's fluid, it's like not good, man. Solve problems of loops in the code. Yeah, I have some problems. Solution problems, a massive amount of working hours. Massive hours. Efficiently manage problems and solve them one by one. Don't stop learning different steps for each problem, and compromise and hard work. That's all. That's who I make for this game. That's all. Thanks for watching.
Is it working now? Good. Hello, my name is Isak Engdahl. I'm from Sweden. I work as a project manager in a mining company. I am on study leave, so I would like to learn some coding here at IronHack. I like guacamole, and I like guacamole games at Tivoli's. So why not make a guacamole game? So the game features are very simple. I guess you have played a guacamole game in an amusement park maybe before. I hope you have. It's very fun. But with this, you have amazing background music. You have you can whack the guacamole with a taco chip. And when you're leveling up, when you're scoring 10 points, you get a high rate. The rate is increasing, the music. And the playback rate of the music and the, yeah, so you eat higher at a higher rate. And it works on mobile as well. That was an issue I had. I was not able to work with a mouse pointer as I have an icon as a pointer on a desktop version. But I was able to do that with changing cursor to pointer. Then it was working on touch device as well. That's all. Very short presentation, 3 slides. I will do a demo. I will turn off the sound for all the Mexican people here. let's see if we can, if it works. Otherwise, it's just. Okay, so you're gonna hit the guacamole, okay? Oh, shit. Okay, so then you can score up to 10 and your lives goes down. Yeah, and that's all about. Done. Thank you very much.
Hi, my name is Andrea, and I'm going to present first the game, so then you can understand how it works when I explain it. My background is of architecture, so it was quite a challenge for me to code and everything. And well, I have to thank Mitchell and Andreas for the help and support during the game. And well, it works like that. Here you first choose a color. For this time, I just did with 3 colors. Then you can write your name. And now the game starts. There is a counter. Then you play it. Like, it's for 2 people. So it works like this. And each time somebody wins, it appears a message. So the idea is how many games you can make during this time, and then it will show how many points each one made. So that's when finish. And if you want, you can start a new game and do all over again. I don't know what's going on. Oh my God. What do I do? Finally. Okay. No, it was because the screen is different here, so. Yeah, well, this is a game, tic-tac-toe. The additional features that I add was like player's name. I made two options, choose three colors, but it could be more too, and set time to 60 seconds. Basically, it was this. This is was kind of the structure with HTML, CSS, also using Bootstrap, and two files of JavaScript. And then what I did, I create a board in Tic-Tac using a two-dimensional array, and I make prototypes for this game. This is like the logic part of the game. It's kind of itself, it works for itself. And I create six functions, check winner to choice, show winner one, show winner two, what happens when there's no winner, and the total score. Well, this is how I check the winner. It's like I compare, each item is changed in the board, and when every item of one row or one column or a diagonal is the same, it calls the show winner function, and also restarts the game. Restarts like clears the board to continue playing, and I'll set the time there. Here is how it's changed each time it presses the button, from the original board to X in this case, but also to O. And the end, you call the function game check winner to know if there is a winner after the board change. This is a prototype of show how what it happens when appears, you know, the yellow stuff saying who's the winner. That's how it works. I make many console logs to make sure that it was working. It was quite long, but yeah. This is linked with the other JavaScript file. And this is the function of the total score, the last one that you see. This is the other JavaScript documents. Basically here is the one that connects with a browser. That is like what happens each time you do click in each cell of that TikTok game. And for example, first I declare the variables, then what happens when when you choose the color in the first part, then when you choose the name, submit button, and yeah, that's it. This is to start. This is inside how I did it to when you choose a color. That's basically working with a CSS, HTML to change it dynamically. And here is how it works with the names of the players. Actually, when you press the button, the second submit button of the second player of the game is when the counter starts. And I put it here. Like 60 seconds. This is the function that clears the board. Every time there is a winner or no winner, it cleans the board so you can continue playing for 60 seconds. And that's how I make to change from one player to another and stuff. Yeah, this is actually how it looks like the HTML file. I divided it in two parts, in the navbar and the other one that is all, where it's also divided in the main board, which is table tic-tac, and I put an ID from every cell of tic-tac so it can recognize every time you do the click. And finally, the buttons of counter, of the start, and the pop-ups that by definition don't appear, but then I make it appear calling them in the JavaScript. And that's it, thank you.
This is all. Okay. hello, my name is Pierre. So the game I'm going to present to you is the King's Game. So I don't know if you heard about it. It's a drinking game, basically. So it's been around for quite a while. It's very popular in France, in the US as well, I think. So a little bit about myself. So I'm French. I'm 30 years old. I'm a business major. I've been working 5 years in France and in China as a purchaser, so I've literally no background in coding, and you're gonna see it after. basically, what I wanted to do is go back on everything we've seen from the beginning, because getting to the coding part was quite hard for me. So I wanted to make sure I mastered pretty much everything we've seen. So I tried to make something quite simple, and in the end, it got to be quite more complicated than I foresaw it, let's say. So basically, the technologies I used were HTML, CSS, JavaScript, like everybody. I used jQuery to get familiar with it, although it was not necessary. A bit of GitHub, but not enough, I guess, and Bootstrap as well. So basically the game, you have a set of rules,
forms that a player, that all the players need to fill in to get information from them. And then you have the table of the game where you see the game going on. So as I said, it's a drinking game. Basically, like, I came up with this idea because I went snowboarding 2 weeks ago, no, 3 weeks ago, and I couldn't find the game online, so it was really annoying. And I really want to give back to the community, so I worked on this. So basically, it's a 2-6 players, 2-6 players. I guess it's a lot more fun if it's 6 players than 2, but everything's possible. And you have 10 rules that are attributed to any of the card you pick. So it's a preview of like the game itself. So you have a little avatar. I wanted to make something funnier, but I didn't have enough time. And basically, they have their name, the drinks they have, which is like the points, basically. And then they have a set of rules that appear here. And so, well, you have to remember a lot of things, but it's quite fun. So let's try it. So basically, you start with a little reminder of the rules. So it's a lot of giving drinks away, so it's pretty simple. On some occasions, you have to attribute drinks randomly if you're a male player, a female player, that you something you set up in the beginning. You have other rules that appear. And yeah, let's see the game itself. So I pre-filled in the form so that we can go faster. So you have some female players, some like the drinkers, and then you submit it. And basically you start. So I really put everything on the layout because so basically when you stick on the you can click on the stack and then it starts. So right now it tells me give away one drink. So Sophia is gonna give one to anyone, let's say to Princess Leia. It's gonna increment, basically, so it's quite simple. You have pair bridging, so it increments your drink and you give away one another. So let's give it to Tony Montana, and you can go on like that, inventory rule. So it's really like one person needs to monitor to be behind the little computer and the rest can enjoy it. So that's it, basically. I thought it would be a lot more simple, but in the end, like, maintain it with the architecture was quite complicated because there are so many rules that are imbricated. So, like, the people who helped me on it, I think realized it was a lot of function coming together. So I really want to thank Alex, who helped me a lot, and Michelle as well. Thank you. And I'm quite happy of the outcome because it made me see again all the things that were really unclear to me. So I guess on the learning curve, it's quite a good thing. So thank you very much.
Okay, hi everyone, my name is Alex. I'm going to show you my project, my first project in Aerohack. So, I'm from Barcelona, I'm 25 years old, and I'm finishing my degree in industrial engineering. I don't have, I mean, I know how to code in MATLAB, but it's not, it doesn't look like JavaScript and any other language, coding language. So yeah, I was feeling a little bit lost at the beginning. And I think this project was a good practice to start mastering all the concepts we learned through these 3 weeks. So my game, it's a simple game. It's the typical who wants to be a millionaire question game. Basically, you have a question and you have to answer the correct, well, you have to pick in the correct answer. I put three wild cards, so you can delete the 50% of the wrong answers. Another wild card that gives you 45 seconds of extra time in case you want, I don't know, if you want to check the correct answer in internet or whatever. And then the Joker wild card gives you directly the correct answer. So you can use one of these wild cards once. So you have to choose it in the right moment. Technologies I used, basically HTML, CSS for the interface, and JavaScript for JavaScript jQuery for the coding of the game and the logic. And then while Bootstrap, actually, it wasn't as helpful as I thought because I lost 2 days because of an issue. I think it's because of Bootstrap, but I don't know. I still don't know what happened there. But my HTML and CSS, I don't know, they did something wrong inside, or but I lost too much time on it. How I made it, I tried to use all the things we learned we did until now in IdleHack. So I use function methods, variables, loops, and I work a lot with array and objects. Basically, all the questions are inside of an array. So it's an array of objects. And this was the hardest part of my project because I had to work with randoms inside this array of objects, and I had problems to remove some content of the array, and I mean, it was a little bit chaotic at the beginning, but I ended by understanding how to manage all these things. So yeah, that's what I just explained, and I'm gonna show you the game. So yeah, if you want to help me to choose the right one. No idea? Okay, let's use the 50% wildcard. What would you say? The second one? Okay, game over. Nice job. Let's try again, you one. There are some really hard questions, I know. Let's use the Joker. Okay, so now we see the correct answer is this one. Yeah. No idea, right? This one, yeah? Well, you see, there are really, really, really hard questions. I mean, so yeah, that's the physique. there's also easy questions, but I mean, there's a little bit of everything. So yeah, if you have any questions? No? Yeah, perfect. Well, the last one?
Yeah, where did you get the questions from?
There's actually in GitHub, there's a project of this kind of game, but I used the questions he used. So I didn't have to think about questions and losing even more time in making a super huge array of questions. So yeah. Anything else? Okay, thank you.
Hi.
Okay. Hello, my name is Brian. I'm from Barcelona, and my project is called Video Poker. Okay, first of all, the video poker is a typical machine that are in the casino, where you basically have to make a bet and it displays 5 cards. You can redraw as many cards as you want, and the game checks if you get something. And if you get it, it multiplies your bet by the pens of you get. Okay. Wait. Why I choose it? I choose it because I love to play this kind of game that mixed luck with the ability of with some skills. So this kind of game, it's so funny for me, and video poker was a good idea to do my first project. About my challenge, my main challenge was, how can I check what I get when the final 5 cards are chosen? How can I get what I get with the, how can I check it? So I decided to make a final array with the 5 cards and group it by the same rank cards. So then I could check if my length it varies. If it's the same length of 5, it means that I don't have any equal card. So I can discard the pairs of the 3 of kinds, the full house, etc. If I have the length of 4, only I can have the option of the pair. And if it's 3, I just have the option of be a 3 of kind or 2 pairs. And finally, if the length it's become 2, I only have the option to check if it's a full house or a 4 of kind. The technology what I use is basically what we learned in the previous week. So it's HTML, CSS, JavaScript, jQuery for the DOM manipulation, and a little of Lodash for some small things. That's my GitHub graph to see my commits. Mostly I work in Monday and Tuesday, and finally on Wednesday and Thursday. It was just for some extra design that I wanted to change. Now, let's see a demo of the game. Okay. Oh, fuck. Okay, we have the screen when we saw the what we get. the pay table, the or bankroll, the start button, the redraw button, and what we want to do. And a help button that it gave us the easy the instruction of the game and what are our objective that I make it when we get 10,000 we win the game. Okay, let's make a bet. If they play the five first cards, we can, I don't know, maybe this. Wait. We get nothing. So we can bet again. Still nothing. No. Three of kinds, and you know, if we lose our bankroll, we lose the game. So that's it. If someone have any question or something. So thank you to everyone. Okay.
Hello, my name is Imre, and I have a background in human studies. I've been dabbling with coding for something like a year. I was thinking that, okay, it would be enough for me to feel confident here at this course. It turned out that I was wrong. Never mind. I have this modest title here, Game of the Year. And let's see if I can make this thing work. Yep. Apparently not. Just very quickly to show you how it looks like in the start. Then this is the beef, so to speak. Short test. Can you guess which of the four translations is the right one for this word, which is, by the way, in Finnish. I tell you which one. Wife carrying. It's a very popular sport in Finland. Right? Then this is how it looks in the end. Difficulties I had in this game, by the way, I'll get back to the game after I talked about these things and the challenges I faced because, I show a demo. Right in the beginning, I had this problem with figuring out what kind of arrays or arrays to use with the words that are used in the game. And I settled down for an array of objects with a key value pair name, which is the word in Finnish, and then the translation, which is badminton. Then I was thinking about the main difficulties I had in my code, and there were many, there were plenty of them. I don't want to bore you with the complete list, but I think the most difficult part for me was to figure out how to generate randomly different words, like first the Finnish word, and then the four different translations for them. I had to figure out how to generate the Finnish word randomly, the four translations, possible translations randomly, make sure that none of the four different translations repeat themselves, that you don't have the same translation on the same card, and also making sure that you have one correct answer in one of the cards. And in the logical part of my JavaScript file, so I had this logic index.js. I had these functions helping me with this, and then in the application JS, a little bit more code with all kinds of random number generating things. I know that I wouldn't have been able to do this without the help of our TA, Michael, so I want to thank him for all the help that he has given me during making this call. And now, for the demo. Before showing the demo, why I came up with this game is, first of all, the obvious need for a game like this. Like, there are millions of advanced students of Finnish who want to revise their vocabulary in sports. By the way, I'm just kidding. Sorry. Okay. So there are not so many students who need this, but anyway. There was also the fact that I wanted to do something super challenging. So here goes. Here is the game. Right. There is sound to it as well. Okay, and there is a restart button as well. Right, that was all. Thank you for your attention. If you have any questions, shoot. Yeah?
What's snow surfing?
Sorry?
What's snow surfing?
Snow surfing in Finnish is lumilautailu.
No, but what it is?
Snow surfing, okay. For a moment I thought that you were just testing my Finnish. It's basically, you have a snowboard, and I don't know, I thought that it's not snowboarding, because that's something else. I have to look into it. Don't know. Yeah, it might be. Yeah, okay. All right, thanks.
To take the micro. As always, I don't know. I don't know what to say. The first thing is good job, guys. I'm very impressive about all of your projects. As I said at the beginning of the course, it was, we had like different levels, but I think at the end, all of you approached the purpose of that module, no? The module two, the module one. So to make a game, we see different levels, but it's amazing, no? What they did during 1 week. So, one applause.